Hello and welcome to another episode of Here's Why with Mark and Eric. So Eric, I kind of feel like I should put on a tinfoil hat before I ask this, but is the singularity upon us?
Well, before I answer that, I gotta tell you, you might be cute with a tinfoil hat on, but... Anyway, first of all, let me tell you what the singularity is and what people mean by that. They mean that moment in our history when machines get to be smarter than humans. And it's a subject of a lot of discussion because people fear what will happen when we get there because machines might start bossing us around and telling us what to do. But the reality is that we have a long way to go before that happens. So, for example, one thing that machines would need to be able to do is set a goal or decide on a goal on something they would like to accomplish. They would then need to be able to make a plan to pursue that goal, and then they would have to execute all the steps of that plan. We're a really long way from that happening. Okay. So what we really see most of the time now is what I'll call point solutions to specific problems.
What is a point solution?
So I'm glad you asked, because I'm actually going to give you a little demo of one.
Okay.
But the short answer is that a point solution is where you get a solution to a very specific set of problems. So I'm going to show you that right now. Where is the Empire State Building?
Empire State Building is at 355th Avenue, New York.
Who built it?
The Empire State Building was designed by William F. Lamb.
Restaurants.
Here are the listings for restaurants near Empire State Building.
So when you look at that, you'll notice that what happened is that I only used the phrase Empire State Building once in that whole sequence. And it remembered all the context of that conversation much like a human being would. And that's a really kind of an interesting thing. And this notion of understanding context is an important step forward. And you can actually go further with these queries. I can also ask it after it gives me the list of restaurants to give me directions to the third one. And it will actually do that. So it's really pretty sophisticated. But this is a very specific problem that they solve. And there's like literally millions of other problems they haven't even derived a solution to yet.
Well, what about this knowledge vault from Google that we keep hearing about? Is this connected to this in some way?
We heard about the Knowledge Vault because a guy called Kevin Murphy did a presentation at a conference, I think in August of last year. And then he did another one in August of this year, something like that, rough time frames. But after that second presentation, a lot of press people picked up on it and they started pushing out this publicity about the Knowledge Vault. And here's a big step forward. That Google's taking. But it turns out that it's really only just a research project at Google. It's not really in development right now, but it is meant to be a step forward by Google in the right direction. But you can think of it as implementation of a whole new set of point solutions rather than having gotten to some major leap forward.
Okay, that's helpful in understanding that. But I guess just wrapping this up, then looking forward to the things that you just talked about and this kind of new world where machines will really be able to anticipate and answer questions and give us information in the way that humans do, how long do you think before that's really happening, before something that would be recognizable as what you described is a reality?
Well, in my opinion, you're probably talking about decades. There's a lot that needs to happen. There isn't enough processing power available to solve these problems. And that assumes that you know what problems you're trying to solve. So there's a ton of work that remains to be done. It's one of the reasons why Google is investing in quantum computing and trying to develop that. I really do think we're a couple decades away.
Yeah, but we should expect to continue to see incremental improvements all along the way and more intelligence built in. It's kind of exciting, interesting to watch.
And while we're at it, when we're done with this, we better go ask the computer over there if we did this okay.
Yeah. I, for one, welcome our robot overloads. But thank you for joining us for this episode of Here's Why with Mark and Eric. A great and interesting article that Eric wrote about the Knowledge Vault is linked below here, so check that out, and we'll see you next time.